Give it up for Robert Murray.
Thank you very much, everybody. I'm very glad to be here this evening at the Unurban. I was thinking about my old job earlier today, and it amazed me how many coworkers I had that had extra incomes by doing other types of work. Sometimes what they would do on their side jobs, if you want to call it that, would leak through to the job they had with me. You know, one guy in particular was always fun to talk to because he used to referee football and basketball games, you know, on weekends. So it was always funny for me to talk to him in the audience, I mean, in the office. Hey, Robert, time out, man, yeah. Hold on, I've got something to say. You know, a lot of the people, they've been getting offsides with the things they've been doing around work, and I was hoping you and me could kick around some ideas that might be cool. So, you gotta let me know what you think, because we're doing a lot of changes and I wanna make sure that we don't impact safety. Yeah, because I know if we put our two heads together, you know, the way you think and the way I think, that we can come up with an idea that's gonna be a winner, you know, for sure. So I was like, okay, what you want to talk about? I was thinking, doing a lot of thinking today, actually. it really surprises me that, well, some of you already know because you've seen it. I've got a beat-up car. Matter of fact, in my old job, they voted my car most likely to start a fire. So I wasn't allowed to park on the first floor. I had to park on the fifth floor of the parking structure sort of thing. And sometimes I would give people rides, and I don't mind if you have a GPS and you're in my car and you turn on, you know, your GPS. But I've got a buddy that he's got a very annoying GPS. As a matter of fact, I call it a TMI GPS, because it tells you more than you need to know to get to your destination. He's got it set on a prospector voice, you know, like, glory be, we're taking a ride down. You know, and he'll turn it on, and I'm like, now you just head forward a little bit more, I reckon. Now, this neighborhood you're in right now has all kinds of glorious graffiti. That's right, take a look off to your left and your right. Now, you're getting real close. In about three more blocks, you're gonna find a great place to buy some weed. And after that, if you take a left turn at the next block, why, you'll be in line for one of the best blowjobs you ever had. If you stop by and see that lady. Anyways, I was like, oh man, hey, shut it off. It's telling me more than I want to know. At least his is getting a little bit carried away. Here's what else I want to share. I went to a concert a while back, Tom Jones concert. He's one of my favorite performers. And we shared things here. Now, it was surprising me that how many women were throwing their underwear at the stage, you know, at Tom Jones. And I wasn't throwing none of my drawers up there. But it got me thinking, I wonder when that started, because I wonder what it would have been like in the 1860s, you know, if women got that kind of, you know, excited about seeing the performers back then, you know, because you picture a guy in those days, I dream of Jeannie with the light brown hair, you know, and then maybe one of the ladies in the audience were like, I do declare that handsome singer on stage is make me want to wiggle out of this petticoat. You know, because back then they had those real big rings, right? So I guess they probably had to get their friends help. Like, I think I'm just going to get out of this for, hold on. I know if I get enough momentum going, I can just twirl this around toward the stage and blast him with it. With the light brown, whoa! none, and the rings of that petticoat go flying past the guy. Yeah. I'm like, yeah, man, I bet they had to duck out. Now they can just kind of reach out a hand and grab it, you know, sort of thing. How am I doing on time?
Oh. Okay.
Thank you very much, everybody. My name is Robert.
Yeah.